Fashion. I'm here at the Hub Culture Pavilion in Davos, very pleased to be joined by Adi Ignatius, Editor-in-Chief of the Harvard Business Review. Thanks for coming along.
Yeah, it's fun to be here.
So tell me about the Internet of Things. It's been a big topic for you here this year.
Yeah, it has. It almost seems like the kind of unofficial sub-theme of this year's Davos is people call it different things, Internet of Things, Industrial Internet of Things, Smart Connected Products. That I guess there are two areas that's interesting. One is the pure technology, and we all know examples of, you know, your refrigerator, when you're shopping in the mm-hmm. supermarket and your refrigerator is telling you that you should buy, you know, eggs. It's all mm-hmm. sort of connected. But at a more profound level, I guess on the technology side, I met a real estate guy in Netherlands who, you know, has just built a building that is probably the smartest building that's been constructed. I think Deloitte is moving into it. It's in Amsterdam. And, you know, there are thousands and thousands of sensors and, you know, not only telling the people who are operating the building about, you know, the quality of the energy use and the efficiency and whether the light bulbs need to be repaired, mm-hmm. but even monitoring kind of use in of different parts of the building. You know, the cleaning staff, for example, will have data as to whether they need to, you know, clean the stalls mm-hmm. on a particular day, because all of that stuff is tracked. It's just, I mean, basically it is, we have the ability to record all this data, that there's this inevitability, therefore, that we will use it and we'll look back a few years from now and say, you know, why did we fly planes without keeping all the data on what the engines were doing? You know,
right.
How did we miss mm-hmm. that opportunity? So that's one thing. And then on the second level is the strategic level.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where it gets interesting, particularly for the Harvard Business Review, that every company can decide to, okay, we do what we do, we make a product, or we get LinkedIn in some sort of basic way, or we kind of completely reinvent ourselves and become part of this really complicated, interconnected infrastructure. And it's, you know, it's kind of the strategic challenge, opportunity that sort of every company will be facing in the coming years. So, you know, people are talking about that a lot here.
I interviewed the chairman of Audi about his
yeah.
About the technology that they're using. It's incredible about how connected every part of the car is going to be, and it's happened so fast.
Yeah.
Does it feel like innovation is speeding up in the kind of times that you've been coming to Davos?
You know, it feels like it. I mean, anyone who's alive now feels like it. There are social scientists who say that is nonsense. That mm-hmm. that's just a trap. That, you know, and they pull out these quotes saying, you know, things have never changed so quickly. You know, mm-hmm. and of course they're from mm-hmm. 1920s or something like that. That we've always felt this. We've always felt like
right.
we can't possibly keep up with the pace of change.
Right.
I think it's different. And I just think, you know, technology and data are you know, disrupting, to use mm-hmm. an overused term, everything, everybody. So I'm in the media business. You know, we are doing fine. We are also scrambling to reinvent a business model
mm-hmm.
so that it's not too late. I don't really know anybody in any industry who isn't thinking the same way. And that can't be normal.
It's the new normal.
It is
another overused term.
Exactly.
So, what's 2015 going to hold for you?
Well, Harvard Business, we are, you know, we've never been sort of stronger, never been healthier, and it is not sustainable. So, we are, you know, what is an editor now? An editor is somebody mm-hmm. who thinks about strategy and business models. So, we are completely kind of reinventing what it means to be a subscriber, what it means to be a member, whatever you call it, of Harvard Business Review, and probably January 2016, we'll come up with a pretty dramatically different offer
mm-hmm.
that probably involves a lot more things, a lot more content, but is a completely different kind of mix and relationship.
And you can still make money.
That's the plan.
Adi, thank you so much for stopping by
sure.
Hub Culture
yep.
Pavilion here in Davos, and I'm Edie Lush.